สวัสดีครับ and good afternoon. Today is Monday, the 18th of January 2021, and this is the English language summary of the daily press briefing here at the Center for COVID Situation Administration, or CCSA. Just now, in the Thai language version, we had the assistant spokesperson, Dr. Apisamai, who is a psychiatrist, give us some of the updates regarding the COVID situation, in which I will summarize parts of that here, as well as provide further information that might be useful and interesting to the English language audience viewing us here in Thailand and on social media from around the world. So firstly, on the general situation and number of cases that we have in Thailand, and we'll have a slide coming up to you there. So the number of active cases, though still under treatment currently with COVID in Thailand, is 3,147. So the new confirmed case that we recorded for today is 369. As the assistant spokesperson mentioned, it seems like a high number when compared to other days when we had around 200 new cases. So today it's 369. However, don't be too alarmed, because this number, the bulk of it, around 275 out of 369, are actually from active case finding. So it's intentional that we went to seek out in different areas to find positive cases. So the majority of this is from active case finding. 82 cases of this number is from local transmission, and 12 cases from within the state quarantine system. The number of new recovery cases that we recorded for today is 191. And cumulatively, since last year until today, over 12 months, over a year, we have now cumulative cases up to 12,423 cumulative. And for cumulative recoveries, it is 9,206 persons. But all in all, of course, in terms of the active case finding that continues to be done, it's very important. We will continue to do that. The number is high, particularly because of the success in the active case finding missions that we have. And of course, they have affected people in particular areas, medical personnel, staff, medical staff, translators, and the like. So just for some observations from the presentation by Dr. Apisamai just now, I'll start off with the teleconference meeting that was held today between the Prime Minister and the governor and the provincial governor of Samut Sakhon province. And we'll have some clips and a still picture coming up to you soon on that. So this is actually not the first time that the Prime Minister had actually been talking to Samut Sakhon provincial authorities on video conference. And what he focused there is, of course, about the updates, the important measures that Samut Sakhon continues to implement. It's very important that we communicate with provincial authorities around the country. The government recognizes this. And as you know, we have been presenting information on each particular province from time to time. And we'll continue to do that. So that's the discussion, some clips there on the discussion this morning. Of course, as you see in the news also, the Prime Minister had been coming out in the news in terms of speaking about the safety of vaccines, that safety is of the utmost importance, and that we will not be using vaccines until or unless only if it is safe. The number of provinces in Thailand that have been affected by COVID still stands at 61, the same as yesterday. So 16 provinces still remain COVID-free. We also want to stress, as Dr. Apisamai had mentioned just now also, that we will not be using the term second wave in Thailand. We'll use the term new wave. We've been using that term since the beginning because the second wave has no relationship to the first cycle. And this new wave we hope to solve and eradicate and control as soon as possible. So hoping that the people in Samut Sakhon and the different authorities and people in different provinces around the country will continue to work together, of course, with public the public and then volunteers as well in order to curb COVID. So moving on to the certain other issues that might be of interest and useful to the English language audience. First is about the case findings in maximum controlled areas and the prevention along the border provinces of Thailand. That according to the Department of Disease Control of Thailand, there might be an elevation, an increase of active case finding missions in maximum control areas to help reduce the risk of further infections in communities, particularly among senior citizens who are considered to be one of the risk groups. And at the same time, the Department of Disease Control stressed that there is also a need to intensify prevention measures along the border areas to prevent the spread of disease from asymptomatic patients, as the number of cases in neighboring countries are still on the rise. And I believe we might have some slides on these issues coming up for you soon. And meanwhile, the Interior Ministry has further issued preventive measures against illegal smuggling of migrant workers into Thailand to stem the spread. All governors in border provinces in Thailand have been ordered to beef up the surveillance along border areas to prevent illegal entry. At the same time, the governors of the of particular provinces have been informed to thoroughly inspect businesses and the private sector in the respective areas to ensure that none of these businesses are hiring illegal persons, illegal migrant workers, in a bid to stop the spread of COVID. In addition, the CCSA encourages everyone to reduce any unnecessary inter-provincial travel for the time being, and please notify administrative and public health officials of any leading information that you might have on illegal activities, be it illegal entry or gray area activities, gray businesses within your local area, within your local communities, in order for the relevant authorities to take the necessary preventive steps and necessary actions. So an update on another issue about the establishment of field hospitals. The Prime Minister revealed that the armed forces, the health authorities, and the administration are looking now to working collectively to set up more field hospitals, especially in high-risk provinces around the country. And there you have some images of those sites being prepared for these new additional field hospitals. So far, there are 10 hospitals established in 10 locations with a number of beds in the thousands, 2,000 plus beds. Six of the field hospitals are located in Royal Thai Army bases with a combined capacity of 1,260 beds. And another three are located at the Royal Thai Navy bases with more than 700 beds. And while the last is located at the Royal Thai Armed Forces base with a capacity of 120 beds. However, these field hospitals will only accommodate the treatment of asymptomatic patients or patients with mild symptoms to prevent the spread of COVID-19 by isolating them from society. Of course, as you know, we have local quarantines and hospital quarantines for those who are in severe conditions. The Prime Minister has also expressed his sincere thanks to various groups of people in society for their compliance and cooperation with the government's COVID-19 measures, especially to private sector, private firms, for offering their facilities to set up some field hospitals at the now, which is of course an urgent mission to treat patients, both Thai nationals and non-Thai nationals and migrant workers as well. So that's the update for the field hospital. Another piece of information important in terms of our cooperation and partnership with international organizations. As I mentioned on Friday, that we'll have some information presented to you regarding our cooperation with the today with the International Organization for Migration, or IOM, particularly regarding a platform for information in English, Myanmar, Lao, and Khmer languages. So as one of the issues for migrant workers is the lack of access to information caused by language barriers. I think that's prevalent around the world. The International Organization for Migration, or IOM, in partnership with local civil society groups, migrant working group, and international agencies, have developed an information hub called Mit Thai. Mit Thai in Thai means friends of Thailand. So this portal, this website you can see on screen, provides information in multiple languages, including English, the language Lao, Khmer, Myanmar, with key information ranging from employment in Thailand, referral services, up-to-date news regarding the COVID situation, to guide as guidelines for workers during the COVID pandemic. This hub will be useful to migrant workers in keeping themselves informed and safe. One additional hub, and you can see on screen that has been put up on screen, two infographics in different languages of our neighboring countries. So the CCSA encourages the public, actually, you can also make use of this website as an information hub. For those who speak the languages that I mentioned, you can scan the QR code that you see on screen or visit the website of Mit Thai, which is World Wide Web, Mit Thai, MITRTHAI, mitthai.com. So just to emphasize once again that the pandemic does not and will not discriminate against race or gender. That has been proven. We're in this fight together, and only by helping each other that we can overcome the pandemic once and for all. We might be seeing a rise in cases in Thailand in terms of the daily numbers in Thailand, but as I mentioned before, those are numbers of cases that we have sought out, that we have tried to root out and discover through our active case finding missions around the country. And I've talked a bit about that already, that in one single day, we have multiple missions ranging from clusters of visiting factories with a target cluster of 50 persons, and another factory perhaps 50, another market perhaps 200 or 300. So it depends on each day. And that number continues because the active case finding is very important in our context. So rest assured that the government is doing our utmost to keep everyone in Thailand safe and informed. So by staying tuned to the information from reliable sources, we'll continue to disseminate information and keep you up to date. As for the vaccines, of course, that's a very important issue right now, still being on the way to being finalized in terms of the analysis to ensure high efficacy rates, as I mentioned. We've been asked for the clinical trial results of the various pharmaceutical companies that we have been in touch with, leading to the arrival and procurement of these vaccines in February and in the months ahead. The Prime Minister has reiterated that no vaccines will be given unless they are thoroughly studied. I'd like to repeat that. I mentioned that in the beginning of this briefing. No vaccines will be given in Thailand unless they are thoroughly studied and determined in terms of their safety and in terms of their side effects. And the best vaccine for the time being, until the vaccine arrives in Thailand, is of course our own mindfulness and our own caution, our own precautions in following the preventive measures and disease control measures that we have been talking about for many weeks now. And of course, as recommended by the medical personnel, and you will call DMHTT. So that's very important. It remains very important. So this is what I have for today. I'd like to thank Dr. Pisamai, the assistant spokesperson who came in place of Dr. Thuy Sin for today. We'll be having alternates in terms of the Thai language version from time to time. Nevertheless, we will still provide you with this daily update with the most accurate as possible, most transparent and most inspiring words that we can give to you, because we are all in this together. So please stay safe, everybody. And we're in the beginning of the week today. It's Monday. Have a wonderful, have a fruitful week, and have a healthy week as well. Thank you for your attention, and see you tomorrow. สวัสดีครับ
ครับขอบพระคุณนะครับท่านณัฐภานุนพคุณนะครับรอง